This video is part 2 of 2 NTRBOOT guides, and this time I will review about R4i B9S Flashcart. And I will show you how to install boot time strap using this flashcart on the latest 3DS firmware. First of all, I would like to say thank you once more to 3dsflashcart.com for sending me 2 flashcards to review. They are one of the trusted flashcard sellers on the internet. So go ahead and go to their website to start shopping for 3DS stuff. You can find the link to the 2018 R4i SDHC Gold Pro flashcard review in the description below. This video is all about the R4i B9S flashcard. Let's open the box and see what is inside it. So you will get the flashcard, a USB micro SD card reader, and a little magnet. So again, this is my new 2DS XL. It is running stock firmware 11.6. Let's turn off the console for now. Get the R4i B9S flashcard. Notice that I didn't insert any micro SD card to the flashcard. Insert the flashcard into the console. Usually, you can see the flashcard icon on the home screen, but not for this flashcard. The flashcard is pre-flashed with NTRBOOT from the factory, so it won't be detected on the home screen. Now let's prepare to mod the console. Turn off the console for now. Remove the console's micro SD card, but leave the flashcard in its slot. Go to this URL and download the NTRBOOT package. This is the NTRBOOT package, and this is the console's micro SD card. Open the 2 console SD card root folder and drag all its content to the console's micro SD card. Reinsert the micro SD card to the console. Turn on the console and get the magnet. Place the magnet near the ABX button and find the sweet spot that makes the console slip. Remember this magnet position. Turn off the console. Place the magnet on the sweet spot. Then press and hold X, select, and start button, followed by the power button. If done properly, you will see the Save B9S installer screen. Enter the combo keys to proceed. It will start installing the boot time strap to the console. Now you need to turn off the console. Pressing A will bootloop the Save B9S installer. So you need to press and hold the power button to turn off the console. Then remove the console's micro SD card and insert it into the computer. This is the NTRBOOT package. And this is the console's micro SD card. Open the latest Lupa 3DS folder and drag its content to the root of the console's micro SD card. Then replace the existing file. Reinsert the micro SD card to the console. Soon after turning on the console, you will be greeted with the Lupa 3DS configuration screen. Press the down button to select Show NAND or User String in System Settings. Then press A until you see the X mark inside the parentheses. Then press Start to reboot the console. Enter the system settings to find out the kernel version. You should see the sys prefix in front of the kernel version. It means that the custom firmware is running on the system NAND. Now go to the internet settings and turn off the spot pass. This method is known to prevent you from getting banned from the Nintendo network. Turn off the automatic software downloads. And disable the sending of system information to Nintendo. Now we will install some homebrew apps. Run the download play app. We will modify its function temporarily. Press and hold L, down, and select button to open the Rosalina menu. Then choose miscellaneous options. Just switch the HB title to the current app. Then press B button several times to go back. Then close the download play app. Now reopen the download play app. It will open the homebrew launcher. Run the FBI app. Navigate to SD, and then enter the CIS folder. Select the current directory. Then choose install and delete all CIS. Usually, pressing B button several times, followed by pressing Start button, will close the FBI app. But for this case, you must press the Home button and close the FBI app alternatively. Now you can unwrap all the newly installed titles. Now run the DSP1 app. This app is responsible for outputting sound for the homebrew app. Just press B to install it, and it will automatically delete itself. Now you can go to the system settings to update the console's firmware if a newer version is available. As I made this video, the latest 3DS firmware is version 11.6. The system is already up to date. You can close the system settings. Now you can open the Luma 3DS updater to find if a newer version is available to install. As I made this video, the latest Luma 3DS is version 9.0. The system already has the most recent Luma 3DS. You can close the updater for now. Now we need to do some additional steps to complete the guide. Turn off the console. Press and hold Start and Power button to enter God Mode 9. Press the Home button and choose Scripts. Now we need to install Luma 3DS to the CTR NAND, so you can boot the console without the need to insert the SD card. Just set up CTR NAND Luma 3DS script. Choose Yes to continue. Then choose Yes again to unlock the Sys NAND. And then enter the combo keys to proceed. Then press A to continue. And press A again to relock the Sys NAND. Now we need to backup the console's NAND. Choose Scripts. And press Backup Sys NAND. Press A to proceed. It is mandatory to backup the console's NAND, so you can restore it if anything wrong happens. Make sure you have at least 2GB or more space on the SD card, or you will fail to backup the console's NAND. Press A to continue. Now we will clean the SD card by removing some unused file. Press the Home button and choose Scripts. then choose Cleanup SD Card Script. Press A to proceed. Press A to continue. Then press Start to reboot the console. You have completed the guide to mod your console with R4i B9S Flashcart. If you want to flash or restore the flashcard to its original function to play NDS games, then you should continue watching the video until the end. Turn off the console. Remove the console's micro SD card. And remove the flashcard from the console. Then prepare another micro SD card for the flashcard. Now we need to download the flashcard kernel. Go to this URL. And download the latest kernel of your choice. Then you need to download the B9S Flasher. This app will help you restore the flashcard to play NDS games. Go to this URL. And download the B9S Flasher. This is the flashcard kernel archive. And this is the B9S Flasher. This is the console's micro SD card. And this is the flashcard's micro SD card. Open the flashcard's kernel archive and drag all its content to the flashcard's micro SD card. Then open the B9S flasher. Open the Luma folder and enter the payloads folder inside the console's micro SD card. And drag the R4i SD8C firm file to this folder. Then create a new folder named NTRBOOT at the root of the console's micro SD card. And drag the R4i SD8C bin file to the NTRBOOT folder. Insert the flashcard's micro SD card to the flashcard. Then insert it into the console. Then insert the console's micro SD card into the console. Press and hold Start and Power button to enter Luma 3DS configuration screen. Then choose R4i SD8C. This app will restore the flashcard to its original function, which is capable of loading NDS games. Select Restore Red Flash. It will begin restoring the flashcard. Please be patient. Then press Reboot. Now you can see the flashcard icon on the home screen. Try loading the flashcard. You can now add NDS format games to your flashcard's micro SD card. Now you have 100% completed the guide. You can start installing CIA format games and apps using FBI. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it. Please subscribe for more upcoming videos.